In this accessible.org presentation, we will go through a 10-step checklist to making your website ADA compliant. Now, when most website owners ask about ADA compliance, they're really asking, what do I do so I don't get sued over website accessibility? So what we're going to do is we're going to work our way through the practical aspects of accessibility, so making sure that you prevent a lawsuit, and then we're going to work all the way up to best practices for ADA compliance. And one note before we start, this checklist applies to your entire website, but for the purposes of this presentation, we're going to prioritize the five most important issues first. So step one is to fix alt text. Alt text is the single most commonly claimed issue in website accessibility lawsuits, so you want to make sure to prioritize alt text. Now, there are multiple crucial details when fixing alt text that you need to be aware of. So be sure you are familiar with WCAG 1.1.1. You can read the free WCAG 2.1 AA guide on accessible.org to understand the layers and the details behind alternative text descriptions. Now continuing on, oh, and by the way, all of the references that I talk about in this presentation, they're all contained in a companion guide posted on accessible.org. I will link to that guide in the video description. Moving on to step two, fix your form field labels so that there are programmatic labels associated with all your form fields. This is the second most commonly claimed accessibility issue when you factor out the boilerplate claims. So you want to make sure that your form fields are not missing the programmatic labels. And as I have here, most form fields have a visual label or a placeholder, but you need to have a correctly associated programmatic label. For step three, we have one more accessibility issue, which is to ensure full keyboard navigability. So it's not only that you can completely navigate your website without a mouse, you must be able to use the website and all of its various functionality without a mouse. So just know that you need to be able to fully use and navigate your website without a mouse. So this is another specific and critical accessibility issue that frequently comes up in lawsuits. Now, the next step is to get your WAVE errors down to zero. WAVE is a very popular scan. Everybody knows about it. Everybody uses it, including plaintiff's lawyers. So it's always best if you have zero errors returned by WAVE and other accessibility scans. For step five, I have publish an accessibility statement. Now you can publish an accessibility statement at any point, but ideally it's best to have your statement include some demonstration of your commitment to accessibility. And remember, you can always update your accessibility statement after you've taken more action or made other investments. And then step six, I have fix other frequently claimed issues. So of course, the three specific issues that I covered are urgent, and I would immediately fix those issues as soon as possible. But there are many other issues that plaintiffs' lawyers frequently claim. So there are 12 more that just repeatedly come up over and over again. So these should also be prioritized as soon as you fix those initial three. So what I've done is I've created the ADA compliance course. And the ADA compliance course is rooted in the accessibility issues that are claimed over and over again by the most active plaintiffs' law firms. And there are literally over two dozen plaintiffs' law firms who are regularly in the practice of sending out demand letters or filing complaints in court. And I've looked through the complaints filed in court, so I know exactly what accessibility issues are being claimed. The ADA compliance course contains step-by-step instructions on how to fix all of these issues, including the first three that we talked about. Just know that there are 15 issues that come up over and over again. And so the course helps you understand what those issues are, how to prioritize, so what order to fix those issues in, and then how exactly to fix those issues with code examples. So the course really contains everything, and it's going to help you take care of these top 15 most commonly claimed issues that come up over and over again. So with step 7, I have to work towards WCAG 2.1 AA conformance. So if you go through the ADA compliance course and you fix all of the issues that are in the course, you are going to significantly reduce your risk of being sued. And then once you've completed the course, it's always best practice to make your website fully WCAG 2.1 AA conformant. So WCAG stands for the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. And these are the technical standards that we look to as a reference for how to make our website accessible. Now, plaintiff's lawyers leverage many of the success criteria, these technical accessibility requirements. They leverage these requirements and include them and really use them as a basis to sue website owners. So we've already taken care of those most commonly claimed issues. But of course, it's always best to not have any accessibility issues whatsoever. And so that's why I recommend, after you've prioritized the most urgent and critical issues, that you continue on and you make your website fully WCAG 2.1 AA conformant. And the good news is that you're already familiar with many of the success criteria. You've already worked on and resolved many of those success criteria after completing the course. So the WCAG course is another course of mine that's going to tell you, explain all of the requirements, and then it really complements the ADA compliance course nicely, because you can just pick up with those remaining issues that you have, work through the WCAG course, and then implement WCAG 2.1 AA into your content process, your content creation process, and then also your development process. So step 8 is to audit your website. And here we are looking beyond the in-house work. We are going to a technical accessibility expert or an agency with experts, and we're having them audit our website to find any outstanding accessibility issues. If we've already gone through steps 1 through 7, they're going to fix anything that's remaining. So it's really like, one, a review of our work, but then just a review in general to make sure that we haven't missed any accessibility issues, or when fixing our issues, we didn't make the fixes correctly. So an audit would be the next step. It's not absolutely required, but again, you know, if we're trying to really finish this off in terms of reach this summit of WCAG 2.1 AA conformance, this is how we're going to get here, because we need that expertise, the skill, the knowledge, the experience to make sure that our website is free of any accessibility issues. So here I have a third party service provider with expertise and experience in audits. So I reference accessible.org, is highly recommended. And you can also learn how audits work with the accessible.org, how to conduct a website accessibility audit guide. And then of course, step 9, following from step 8, is that we remediate any outstanding issues. So the audit is going to result in a deliverable report. Once you receive that report, you will be aware of the remaining accessibility issues. And then obviously you need to fix those issues. So optimally, the person fixing those will have technical expertise in accessibility. However, you may choose to fix the issues in-house or through a trusted third-party development agency. Either way, you want to take immediate action on the audit and resolve those issues. And then for step 10, the final step in this checklist, I have user testing. Now, user testing is definitely optional, but user testing is very, is a service definitely worth considering, because with user testing, we typically have an accessibility professional with one or more disabilities. Usually that professional is blind or visually impaired, and they're going to be using screen reader assistive technology to go through the website and relay their experience. If we've gone through all of the steps preceding step 10, it's very unlikely that they will come across any accessibility issues. But if they do, That's a good thing because we want to make sure that there are no accessibility issues whatsoever. So here the accessibility professional is going to be relaying their experience as they go through the website. And then after the user testing session is finished, if you order this service through accessible.org, you will have a recording of the session. And then you will also have documentation of the session that's been completed. And this is really the seal on everything and the ultimate finish to an accessibility project. Again, some of these steps are optional, but I've just taken you through, you know, the aggressive approach to where you're attacking accessibility and you are resolving as many issues as you can as fast as possible to reduce your risk as you are working through accessibility. And then we've progressed all the way to step 10, where we are finalizing everything and making sure that there are no accessibility issues whatsoever, and then really going above and beyond to ensure that the website is not only free of technical accessibility issues, but practically we also know it's accessible. So this is the 10-step checklist. A few notes to finish off. You can always skip directly to an audit because here you're not engaged in the early work. You're just going directly to the audit and then having someone else take care of everything for you. Being proactive and taking immediate action is essential to all of this. And you must keep in mind that an audit is only going to find issues. You still need to fix them. So an audit is a very important part of this process. It's necessary to uncover all of the accessibility issues, but that's just going to end up with a report. We still need to take action on that report. And then the third bullet point I have here is attention to detail is critical when it comes to preventing lawsuits. Many website owners aren't paying close enough attention to detail, and it can lead to them being sued again. So, and that's what I have here. Even if you miss a key detail, it can easily lead to a lawsuit, even if you've already been sued once. And then the final bullet point I have is beyond just the services at accessible.org, you can get certification documentation once you reach WCAG 2.1 AA Conformance. And if you visit our documents page, you can actually see examples of this documentation so that you can see what you would get after you have reached full WCAG 2.1 AA Conformance. So I've covered a lot here. There are many resources available to you. I'm going to link to many of them in the YouTube description. And if you'd like to find out more, you can just visit accessible.org.